So there is a very beautiful thing, and I personally love it. Kabira seep samandr ki, khara jal nahi le, pani piye swati ka, shobha sagar de.
What is the meaning of this doha? Anybody would like to attempt at decoding it?
I'd also like to express my sincere gratitude to Mrs. Rashmi Agarwal for consenting to perform with us today. Ma'am is a renowned ghazal, devotional Sufi singer. And she has not only made India's name known in our own country, but she has gone overseas. She has performed in US, UK, Mexico, Uzbekistan, Tajikistan. And she's the first and the only Indian woman to have won the Grand Prix Award at the 9th International World Music Festival, Melodies of the Orient in Uzbekistan. And she's known for performing Kabir Das a lot, which sets the tone for this evening that we, you know, that we are gathered here for today.
ओ जरा हलके गाड़ी हाको ओ मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हलके गाड़ी हाको ओ मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा धीरे धीरे गाड़ी हाको ओ मेरे राम गाड़ी वाले जरा हलके ओ जरा हलके
But today's story when we gonna tell you and introduce you to the Kabir, I'm going to introduce you to the mind of Kabir and why Kabir is still as relevant and all the way more relevant today than it has ever been before. India as a country and as a culture has always assimilated great concepts from all over the world. But parallelly, while that was happening about 11th century, a great revolution happened within Islam also, okay? And that came to be known as a way of being close to God, okay? And the name for that was Sufism. And in those times appeared a baby boy on the petals of lotus flowers in the city of Kashi on Leher Tala Talab.
साहिब कबीर सर्व रंग रंगिया सब रंगत ते रंग न्यारा मो पे साई रंग डारा सतगुरु हो महाराज मो पे साई रंग
profession in the future, he began to create and form these couplets in his head as a outcome of the observation of the world, right? He was not looking forward to create a cult. He was not looking forward to become a guru. He was just reacting to the world around him, okay? He begins to learn many concepts of bhakti, but Kabir was a Muslim. This provides him a very unique position. He could then blend the two and find the essence of two cultures and create something on his own. Now that requires tremendous amount of intellectual exercise, identity crisis, and outcast. He questioned it. And in that questioning, he began to observe and he began to create his own truth of life. And where did he find the truth? He found it in Khajur, in Chakki, in Barsat, in Barish, in Khet, Ped, Pode, you know, Machliyan. And these were the symbols that Kabir began to look at and create his knowledge reservoir, so to say. Finally, he began to create a way of living that has become an integral part of India's fabric. India is nothing without Kabir.
Kabir, hamare liye kya hai? कबीर हमारी संस्कृति है हमारे संस्कार हैं कबीर को समझने के लिए एक बड़ा प्रस्पेक्टिव हमें रखना चाहिए और तब हम कबीर को समझ पाएंगे अंदर अपने आत्मसात कर पाएंगे
कबीर प्रोवाइडेड समथिंग फॉर समथिंग मच मोर अफोर्डेबल लेट्स पुट इट लाइक दैट ओके So he said that you don't need to do rituals. You don't need to do 10 times ghee in your yagni. You can just sit down and do the yagni within yourself. All you need to do is look not outside, but within yourself.
Mala pherat jug bhaya gaya na man ka phe kar ka man ka chhod de man ka phe aakhir ye tan khaak mile धन्यवाद।